So let's make some pho. All right. So normally I would have gotten some oxtail, but they didn't have oxtail, so we're working with short rib today to make our stock, which I mean I'm really looking forward to. It's going to be good fatty short rib. And then we've got some top round that we're going to slice really thin for serving. So what we're going to do is I want to just get a little bit of flavor on our beef. Normally we just need to you just slice it thin and serve it, but I want to give it some time to sort of marinate in a little something, just because we're going to be doing this the broth is going to be quick. We're going to be using some cheats kind of to make the broth, like my good friend the Instant Pot. You guys know how much I love it. So when I say this is quick, this is going to be maybe an hour and a half to make pho. Normally I'd say give it a whole weekend to make a really good rich beef broth. We don't have time for that, so we're throwing some extra flavors in there just to make it kind of as punchy as we can. So we're just gonna crush and peel some cloves of garlic here. Those are gonna go in with our beef. It doesn't need much. We're just putting some garlic in there. We'll crack a little salt and pepper in there as well. Some salt, some pepper. And we're going to do my favorite thing, vacuum sealing. I've been having so much fun with this thing. I've been having so much fun vacuum sealing. Like, it's all I've been doing, like, all of yesterday. And it seals. Great. So, now we have some vacuum sealed beef, a little garlic, salt, pepper, just something to give a little bit of extra flavor to our beef later on. In the meantime, we're throwing that in the fridge. All right, so because we are making a broth, there is gonna be a lot of downtime in this. But for the first little bit, we've kind of got a lot of hands-on work. We're gonna start heating up big old heavy pot here. I guess I'm actually gonna heat that. No. I think since we're just doing a warming, basically a pre thing, I'll just bring these up. Normally I would say, oh, if you're making a stew or something, brown these off, get some flavor on there. But don't really need to do that. Here. All right, so yeah, you can kind of see these little scummy bits, these little nuggets of fat and junk that are starting to pool up in there. Yeah, you can kind of see them on the camera. Those are why we are boiling this once first before we actually start making our stock, because otherwise we're going to end up with all that gnarly inside our stock. And we don't want that. We don't want that gnarly. We want good, clean, hearty, beefy stock. But you can tell the short rib is going to be great. We've already got a significant amount of color change in the water. I mean, part of that's just the juices seeping out and providing some color, but we're going to have a very, very hearty stock out of this. I'm very excited. And I bought myself some extra vegetables. So I can make a veggie stock so I can have soup for the rest of the week. I know. Some carrots. These are homegrown. My dad brought me some carrots he grew. Katsu, we'll see you later. Thanks for stopping by. Got some ginger. Then I got a big thing of fennel. We're gonna be kind of messing with this a little bit. I mean, sometimes you put some fennel seeds into pho, but we're gonna be messing with some whole fennel here. I'm excited.
We're also going to be adding some more
general citrusy flavors to this. I mean, often you'll serve pho with some, you know, squeeze some lime juice in there. We're going to be putting some lemongrass and kefir lime leaves into our stock as well. I know it's not the most authentic, but I'm looking for something to make this a little more summery. To me, pho can be often, it's not heavy, it's a lightweight soup, but it's a fall. It's like, it's what, it, for me, I associate it with eating it on a rainy day. It is already 85 outside right now, and it's supposed to get up to 95 today, so I want something a little more summery. So I can't claim I'm making anything authentic, but look, it's gonna be a beef broth with rice noodles and some beef and a few traditional Vietnamese flavors in there. Be good. What we are gonna do when we get the actual stock going, I am gonna do the actual stock back on the big stove, because then we'll be working on prepping other stuff and doing some coffee and various things over here. So we are gonna do that back. It do boil. We're just gonna give it a minute with this, and then we're gonna dump it, Instant Pot it off to the into the actual stock. So what we're gonna do while that's in the Instant Pot then is we're gonna pull. It's so gnarly. I know this is really gross. It's really gross, but it's so worth it. And because we're doing this, we're gonna come up with a much cleaner, tastier, less. You know, won't have as much of like the irony meat flavor in there, and no bitterness. It's gonna be good. This is gonna be good. So while we get that in the Instant Pot, then we're gonna work on prepping our vegetables, our aromats for the stock. And I think we'll actually start the vegetable stock and get that going, because that's gonna take the longest time to get that. We're gonna get the veggie stock going, and then we'll use what we get out of the Instant Pot to make our beef reduction that we are then going to add into the veggie stock along with all of our short rib after the Instant Pot. That will then give us tasty beef juice. All right. Into this, we're going to put what we're going to use as our aromatics. All right, so we're keeping the root on that because we want it to stick together. Let's throw that down at the bottom. Do the same thing over here. Trim up some fennel. We are just going to use the root end this time around. What I'm going to do is take all these fennel stems and make these into some veggie stock later. Next thing we're going to do is grab our veggie peeler and just really quickly peel down some carrots. You don't really need to if you've washed them real good, since we're just throwing them in the soup. Be part of our stock. I think carrots is probably one of the least authentic ingredients in our pho, but I like, they add a good sweetness to a broth. And normally I would add, you know, serve with hoisin. The grocery store unfortunately did not have hoisin today. I've got some okonomiyaki sauce that might work good, or some tokatsu sauce that might work good too. But we're going to make up for a little bit of it with some carrot, just to give us a little bit of a sweet note. Oh, I just had a weird combination of fennel and carrot that smelled like gasoline for a second. I was trying to figure out, that's not the smell of a gas leak, so what's going on? That was just a weird whiff of fennel and carrot. It freaking smells like gasoline.
Let me smell it.
Doesn't that smell like gas?
Yeah.
Maybe I'm crazy. Maybe I'm crazy. I might be crazy. That's entirely possible. All right. And I'm just peel down a bit of ginger. Doesn't need to be perfect. Really don't need to peel it either. But we're gonna. Oh man, now the fun part comes. So before we throw some water in here, you know we already got the fennel in there? We're gonna get kind of the warming thing, a little bit of star anise. Since we're gonna strain this, I'm not gonna worry about them going in anything. Just gonna do two of those. Doesn't need much. All right, so star anise, cloves, cinnamon sticks, in. Got a little bit of little cheese sauce sachet here. Now, I wasn't able to get fresh lemongrass because podunk grocery store, but what I do have is dried and trimmed lemongrass from Egypt, which I think is neat. So we're just gonna take a little pinch of that. Into a bag there, doesn't need much. Some people like different things in their pho. And that's not gonna work. One of the great things about pho is how many different toppings you can put on. Like a little cilantro. But the other thing I like is really thin shaved onions. So guess what we are going to make using our good friend the mandolin. The mandolinian. The Mandalorian. The white onion. And we're going to cut in half. Alright, so once we've halved and peeled our onion, if you're not comfortable with a mandolin, obviously use a guard. Alright, now we got a whole bowl of shaved onion. We're gonna pull all the short rib out, and we'll save that for later. I might use the bones from that for something else again. Alright, so, got this. You can kind of see it's got some fat on it. We're gonna leave that in there because it's fatty and delicious. You can see this is why we strained it. Get some bits and scum in there. Alright. This is dried rice noodles. I'm an idiot. I forgot the fish sauce. Welcome to Badgersail. I don't remember my own recipes. All right, boiling waddles. Boiling water. On to our noodles. Cut open our, smells good and garlicky. I like it, I like it. All right, I'm gonna get, no boiling waddles. No one needs to know about the boiling waddles, guys. You guys are bullies. All right, step one, bottom of the bowl. Try to separate this into two batches of noodles. Noodle step is complete. Next thing we are going to do is lay over a few pieces of our beef. All right, next up, we're gonna go back here, ladle some of this boiling broth on there. My favorite part. Big old pile of bean sprouts. Big old pile of bean sprouts. We cut a lime into quarters. And then we do a big old squeeze of fresh lime in there. And a healthy drizzle of sriracha. And then you tell Laura to come over to the kitchen. Try out our homemade quick pho. Big ol' bite here with some noodles.
I need a little more lime for me. Mm-hmm. That's darn good.
Noodles are not a good thing to eat on camera. But, it's really tasty.
That broth is so good.
Thank you. Get some onion, get some bean sprouts. That looks fucking delicious. Thank you.
I'm trying to look graceful while eating noodles.
Oh, it's not gonna happen.
It's really good. Like, obviously you could make a richer broth if you had 36 hours or whatever, but this was 2.5. And I'm eating pho for lunch on a weekday.
Honestly, this is a really good Monday lunch.
Yeah. It was 2.5 hours to make with the crappy hot plate and reading chat and getting scotch and making coffee and doing announcements and talking through all the steps. But I think if we just like made this, it would take like maybe 1.5 hours.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's real good.
I would say official time for this would be 1.5 hours. I think we could cut a whole hour if we were just, you know, using the gas stove and yeah. So, coming up here, Laura and I are gonna do a cook-off, like a 20-minute who can make a better meal. We'll invite some friends over to judge, because I don't trust you guys to be impartial. I think you guys are about the furthest thing from impartial. But I appreciate you guys nonetheless. It should be fun. It should be fun. This is really tasty. I'm going to shove my face full of noodles and broth.
Hey guys, Captain here. Just wanted to make some quick announcements. First off, Badger has a blog at badgerfood.club. It is a fantastic ad-free website that gives you inside looks into Badgersail's pantry, mind, and soul. Honestly, all joking aside, it's a fantastic website. Badgers put a lot of work into it, and I really think you guys should go check it out. Once again, that's badgerfood.club. Next up, we've got some quick announcements regarding the upload schedule. Uploads will be happening consistently once every week on Friday, 5 p.m. PST. For any other stream information, stream schedule, anything like that, join our Discord down below. Badger loves all of you. I love all of you. Thank you all so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, tell your friends. We'll be here every week.